Next on the menu from the Olympic Indoor Hall, it's the women's floor exercise final. Eight women qualifying in after the first day of gymnastics competition for the women, and now it comes down to one last performance to see who's going to win gold, silver, and bronze. Representing the United States later will be Mohini Bhardwaj, but right now we start off with Daiane dos Santos of Brazil.
And this, I tell you, Al, could be one of those moments. Way back in 1972, I remember turning my television set on and watching a girl named Olga Corbett captivate the world. This young lady has a lot of those same qualities.
Whoa! That's a tenth of a deduction.
It's a huge ovation here. Tim, you get the feeling maybe on that first pass she just had too much energy.
Well, actually, she even made something that was so difficult, more difficult for this Olympic final. Tries to do an Arabian double front in the laid out position. This is brand new for the Olympic Games. Have never seen this performed.
Wow.
And just has too much energy, takes those steps forward and out of bounds.
We watched her in practice. She was super, super bouncy on the floor. I'm not at all surprised.
And she'll score well below what she did in qualifying, a 93.75. Still to come from the United States, Mohini Bhardwaj, surprisingly the only member of the U.S. team in this floor exercise final. Already having won a gold medal on the night, Catalina Ponor of Romania, and as good as she can be on the balance beam, is as graceful as she can be in floor exercise.
And now, as I said, on balance beam, what she has coming into floor exercise is reputation. Once again, she has a couple of medals last year, silver from the World Championships. This year, the gold medal at the Europeans. tumbling passes, that's going to be your new leader.
Well, if after these Olympic Games, Romanian gymnastics had an IPO, sort of like Google, through the roof.
Very powerful full twisting double somersault. She also does it in pike position, keeping her legs straight.
Of course, coming down to the final tumbling pass, this being her fourth one in the routine. Just a double pike, all she had to do was plant her legs onto the floor, not go out of bounds, not a problem.
And she has been duly rewarded with a 9.75. They just have not been handing out numbers like that on floor exercise. Another Romanian celebration is imminent. Let's get in the head now for a moment of Mohini Bhardwaj. Making the Olympic team was not a guaranteed thing. Getting to the point where she can star for herself, forget it. Now, with the scores that have come so far, she can legitimately think of a medal. Biggest roar so far. She'll keep that one.
She sure will. What an Olympic Games. What a story. This young lady barely made it out of the first round of competition and has gotten better and better and better.
And can you believe that she qualified into this day of competition? She led the team off in the first day of team competition. It was a huge score, not to mention a huge opening tumbling pass. Everybody just kind of gasps when they see Mo do this.
Double laid out somersault, two flips completely in a stretched position, and then she spots the ground, bang, punches that floor, changes direction.
That was the best one we've seen from her.
Great, great stuff.
But it's not scored greatly. Mohini Bhardwaj gets a 9.312. Doesn't love it, and it's another score the crowd doesn't understand.
Well, what they have to understand is the start value of her routine was out of a 9.7, so that's the maximum, but I actually thought that was just a little bit too low.
Looked like Mohini was counting the deductions that she thought she should get with Coach Chris Waller, but she's going home with an Olympic team silver medal. No medal for Mohini Bhardwaj, but she's done a lot of smiling here in Athens. Back to California she goes with that team silver Olympic medal, and the Romanians go back home on about a two-hour flight with a lifetime of stories about what they did here in Greece.